형 말로
말로
말로 말로
말로 말로 말로
We were all going to move to Tasmania together.
Coming cousins or brother or sister.
Hang in there. Hang in there. I would say hang in there and do your thing. Just
Life in this moment so beautiful. Oh, we feel good vibrations from head to toe. After 4 margaritas in Mexico. We've been dancing on sand as the sun gets low. When I feel your touch, I can picture us in the stars above. It's like we're in heaven. I want this forever. You know that I will hold you. Don't be afraid to fall into my arms. You know that I will hold.
I'm doing it again actually, I'm doing my intro again. I was talking the whole time and I just saw it was shooting in time wrap. So here guys, welcome to another vlog. And if you're new here, I'm Sujay, I'm from India, Kolkata. Currently I'm here in Hobart, Tasmania.
Boy, how are you, bro?
Yeah, how are you? Where is BP?
I don't know where is BP. You called him,
right? That's why I don't trust his words. Like if he says he's coming, I always assume like he's gonna come after 2 to 3 hours.
But call him again. So and guys, if you're watching my vlog, you know this is Mr. Joy Paul. You know him already.
And this is my college friend, university friend,
Arsh. He's from Punjab, India. Yeah. We're all from same country.
No, he's become Australian citizen now.
Oh, he's going to be. I think he's going to be.
No, he's already.
Okay, what about you?
Eh?
What about you? You should tell the people the good news.
Yeah, I got my nomination. Just a nomination from Tasmania.
Okay. Guys, he got his 491 visa nomination.
Six years.
After six years. Tell them your story a little bit. What you did in Sydney? I mean like when you came here.
Okay, if I say my story, it's a long story. I came in Sydney, study bachelor's, finished down there. And while studying bachelor's, I was working with catering company as a catering assistant and cook.
Mm-hmm.
And then after moving to Tasmania, I was in the same industry in the hospitality sector. And in the meantime, I was doing my security work in the pub and quarantine during the COVID time.
Then. When did you move here in Tasmania?
I moved here to Tasmania in August 2019, 16th of August. After coming to Tasmania,
what did you study here?
Yeah, 1 year of diploma leadership and management.
Yeah, same. I did same as well.
And then sorry, the COVID.
COVID happened and all.
And pandemic, it continued for like all. Still, it's continuing.
Mm.
But for 6-7 months, the process was stopped. And once it reopened, so I applied on 1st of February.
Yeah.
After applying that, I have to wait for 3 months to grant this nomination.
So which category you got your nomination?
Tasmanian graduates, category 2.
Okay, and what occupation?
Occupation as a cook.
So yeah, luckily he had a job and that occupation is like it's on Tasmanian skill occupation list.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like if you are in Tasmania and if you watch their migration website, they already listed the sectors. So you have to work in those sectors, then only it's possible. Chances are high to get the nominations.
Planning to move here in Tasmania, and if you have a job or you're studying something that they have on their Tasmanian skill occupation list, then there is a high chance of getting a 491 visa or even 190.
Yeah, but most of the people are getting now is genuine people.
Yeah.
They have to show their genuinity, like in terms of work, commitment.
Exactly.
Everything has to justifiable with your lifestyle as well. It's not like you're saying you want to be a scientist, but your work is not related to scientist or something like that. It's an example I'm saying.
Yeah.
It's not gonna work.
Exactly.
Because I had a before I get nominated, there was a bit of drama happened. So yeah. From there, I came to know all this.
Yeah, I think we should mention that actually, because first he just applied for the 491 invitation, just accounting as a like normal occupation, and he got cancelled. But then in his application there was significant changes because he was working in hospitality, and he showed that, and everything was after that.
That means, like, in words I can say accounting is a shit. Like, if you say you, if you're not, I'm an accounting degree holder, but I haven't worked in my accounting field, so I can't make my career as an accountant in future. So I have to make my career in hospitality.
Yeah.
As a cook.
Yeah.
That's what I mentioned after even that, when I got my application cancelled.
Yeah.
So whatever you're doing, whatever you did previously, you have to connect.
Yeah.
From previous to the future as well.
Exactly. I think same goes for me as well. If you don't know my story as well, is like same. I moved here in 2019, and then I was working in hospitality for a long time, like since I came to Australia for a long time, and got everything done, got the skill assessment. You have to be in an occupation where you're working as well, and that makes the application really strong, and you really have to show your commitment to the state and everything. So that
actually the journey, and there was a negative outcome, and then we realized, like, it's already says in the heading, like, skilled migrant, that you have to have a skill.
Well, story, and yeah, it's been a long ride actually, and it's been, I think I've been in Australia already 7.5 years, and finally whatever I could do, I did in Sydney with 90 points. I moved here in Tasmania and still didn't get nomination for accounting. Then I studied leadership and management here, but I was working in hospitality, like I mentioned before. And then I had a skill assessment done with that thing. And then after that, when they added cook or chef in the critical sector here in Tasmania, that time I applied for 491 visa, and I got the nomination straight away. So yeah, I think hang in there, guys. You guys will get it soon as well, but don't lose hope. And anything you want to add, Joy?
Yeah, all the best who are newcomers to this state.
Tell them that when he's got his visa, like his nomination got rejected, he was in like in a very bad space for 2 weeks.
Yeah. I was thinking, like, fucking what should I do, what's gonna be my next step. But
yeah
that time taught me a lot, like, before you apply something, you need to understand behind the story as well. Like, I was himself or herself, get the idea and then work on yourself mostly.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, what skills you get and how you gonna utilize that skills for the particular on this state, like for Tasmania, how is that skills gonna be useful. Even though I can also share you one story. Recently I was talking to one guy from a Facebook. He worked as a cleaner and kitchen hand. Okay, he got his nomination because he mentioned his skill, how he gonna implement that simple skills and how he gonna grow with that skills in future. But he was a background of IT, but still he was working in a sector like it's not a critical sector, it's not a nominated sector as well, but still he got his nomination a few days back. So he mentioned his
which occupation he got his nomination.
Category 2, like me, Tasmanian graduate. He studied 1 year diploma leadership and management.
Mm-hmm.
But he made his career plan like he applied by himself.
Okay.
He made his career like what job he is doing. From there he gonna go up. He showed his skills, simple skills. He showed his the pathway, how he gonna go step by step.
Yeah.
He convinced.
It's pretty much what the picture I see in Australia at the moment. People like especially international students who are living in cities like Sydney or Melbourne, they all wanna move out, go to regional and wanna get this visa. 491 is the most popular one at the moment. And so yeah, guys, just have a good discussion with your agents, with your peers, whoever got 491 visa. see how they got it and check which like the regional area you're moving to, check their skill occupation list if your occupation is there or not, and are you going to work in that occupation or not. So those things matter a lot now. It's not that easy anymore. It has to be really, really, you know, you're working there, you have experience there in that, especially in that particular field, and that will help your application to get 491. I think, yeah, this is our story to get how we got our 491 visa or our 491 story. And
but every journey is worth it. Like the time we the low time as well, when we had a low time, everyone has a low time in yeah. that time period of time we learned a lot. That's what the process of life is. So
yeah, Harsh, you want to say something about your
like best of luck always, you guys?
Yeah, now we are qualified for the next level, like to earn $54,000.
Yeah, yeah.
Hopefully we're gonna make double of that.
Yeah. Hopefully we can make. You were saying, Harsh, anything like?
Oh, that's it.
You wanna tell about your
my story?
Your story? Yeah.
History. We supposed to move together, but I was stuck.
Him and I were going to move together to Tasmania. We're all going to move to Tasmania together.
Yeah.
In 2018, I think in May we were gonna come.
Yeah, yeah, May. 10th of May, I remember.
So which year was it?
2018.
After finishing the bachelor's degree.
Bachelor's, yeah.
Uni, yeah.
Yeah.
So, me and another friend,
mm-hmm.
we came to Tasmania together.
Yeah.
And he moved to Sydney.
Okay.
He thought he's gonna make more money there. Yeah. But he will come back later.
Yeah.
By driving Uber.
Yeah.
Famous.
He was still making good money in Tasmania
at that time,
almost like $1,000 a week.
Yeah.
And he wanted to make some more. He didn't trust that he would get like 489 visa here at that time.
And that time, getting 190 or 489 was a bit easy.
Oh, I would say it was busy. Easy as compared to the
current situation.
Yeah.
But there was a news arise like they're not gonna give 489 to everyone.
Let me hear his story. Yeah. Only. we finished talking.
Yeah, he thought he's not gonna get 489 invitation.
Yeah.
So he decided to move back to Sydney.
Yeah.
And he also convinced me to go back to Sydney because I had only been to Tasmania for like a week.
Mm-hmm.
And we used to live in an apartment. We had like another common friend.
Yeah.
And he was also almost convinced that let's go back to Sydney.
Okay.
By leaving everything.
Mm-hmm.
But he moved to Sydney, and Ksar had given like a bond.
Okay.
To the owner.
Yeah.
So I had already given like a 2 weeks rent and 4 weeks bond to the owner. So I thought I might as well stay for another 4 weeks. I have already given the rent.
Yeah,
I would move back to Sydney after a month.
Okay.
But then somehow the people I used to live with, they convinced me to stay here.
Okay.
They told me, oh, you're not gonna get anything there.
Hmm.
So I just stayed here.
Oh, okay. So you were also thinking of going back to Sydney?
I was going to.
Okay.
Because I haven't never been to the spirit of Tasmania. I thought I might as well go to the go back.
Yeah.
Then I stayed here. Even the other friend, he was also convinced to go to Sydney, and he also stayed because I decided to stay here. So we both stayed here, and unfortunately we got invitation together.
So did you study?
Same
leadership and management for a year.
Yeah, for a year.
Okay, and then after studying for a year, you got your 489 visa.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got the invitation here after studying one year.
Okay.
Yeah.
No drama like what's happening now.
No. Okay. But they were going to abolish the 489 visa.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
in next three, four months of finishing my study.
When you arrived here, yeah.
Even I was scared that time whether I'm gonna get it or not. So
okay.
I applied, and luckily there was election that time in Australia, and they were supporting regional areas.
Yeah.
And they said they're gonna get more invitation to the regional areas.
Mm-hmm.
So during that time, they distributed like 489 visa, 489 invitation to everybody.
Okay.
Yeah, in regional. So luckily, I think I got the invitation in 1 month.
Oh,
so I applied
great.
For visa. I got the visa after like another 1.5 months.
Okay.
It was so quick, I was so lucky. Otherwise, a lot of people were waiting
for that,
for the visa after applying for the nomination.
I
know people who waited like 1.5 years
to get the visa.
Yeah.
Okay.
But luckily, me and another 2 friends, we all got our nomination and visa like within 3 months. Everything was sorted. Yeah.
Okay.
So that way we saved like almost one year. And
it has
already been like 1.5 years now since I got my visa. So in November this year, so I will be applying for the 887,
which is a PR.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So basically all sorted now.
Okay. You want to say anything now?
Yeah.
Whatever you're thinking.
It looks clear to in his process as well, but there was ups and bitter down.
Yeah, ups and downs is always a part of a life.
It's not like it's clear crystal. It's not a clear crystal picture. Like he came in and applied.
Yeah.
But there was a lot of news was around that time as well. That 489 will abolish.
Yeah.
Will
yeah.
not give 489 to everyone. But
they will give 491 and all.
But there are few people didn't get it as well. There are few people who were supposed to finish the course on time, but. Finished the course on time, but didn't get the certificate on time.
Yeah.
They applied a bit late, but already the 489 nomination has been closed. So those people have stuck, and they have to apply 491, which is 5 years visa, and you have to fulfill the criteria of 3 years of earning $54,000.
Yeah.
So what it looks like, the pictures, oh, you get it. Some people get it, 489, 491. It's not easy. No one has got their visa easily. Maybe few people were lucky enough, but they might have a good skill. That's why they got their nomination or visa.
Yeah.
But not everyone.
And life is full of surprises actually. I'm happy for this friend who got his citizenship, but he just came like 1 month
ago.
Yeah,
Masood, like
Mr. Masood.
I'm the only one who received him from the airport.
He received my friend Masood from airport when Masood came in Australia in 2014 February.
2014, yeah, February.
And Masood got his citizenship when like few days ago, and we are still in.
We're still in like not in the visa yet.
We are still waiting just for a 491 visa to be approved, man.
That's called luck. That's
it's
called
funny.
Not luck.
I mean, yeah.
Maybe not luck. It's occupation as well. He studied in IT.
Masood
studied accounting.
Masood studied IT actually, information technology. So when he cleared his PT, the eight next each. Month he got his 8H. He got 8H. He got his permanent residency invitation to apply for. Then when I cleared my PT, my NATI, my PY. But I didn't get because it was accounting. You know, like it's luck or it's life, how you wanna say it. Things change. They changed the rule. The points were higher. Nobody knew like what's happening. Are they gonna call or not? Yeah, it was a bit of a struggle during 2019 when I moved here with all the dilemma that if I'm gonna get the invitation or not. And that time I just moved to Tasmania like. To open another door for me.
And yeah, when I was moving to Tasmania on the way of my traveling, he messaged me. Hey, I've seen your story. Are you moving to Tasmania?
Yeah, see.
On that time, I was driving.
And we are all like, we all just moved to Tasmania to open another door for us and see if this works or not. Since Sydney thing didn't work. And I guess a lot of international students can relate.
But I think,
with me.
I think we moved to Tasmania is a better move. Once you move from,
but we didn't know, right?
Yeah,
we didn't know that it's gonna happen or not. It was just another decision to make it happen, to make it, you know, because we love this country, we want to stay here, and we left our country when we were really young.
Actually, we want to spread.
You know, this guy.
Of course, we are boys. We are
so,
into girls.
So. Yeah, obviously.
And girls are into boys. So Indian, Aussie boys and fucking boys are into white.
So yeah, guys. If I did intro of this vlog or not, since if you're still here and watching our stories, and
even though if you're not, if you watching got, just spread these stories to Chinese, Nepalese, Taiwanese,
I think everybody can relate to it. Yeah.
স্নান করতে এসেছে
কি বলছো বাড়িতে বসে কি করবে
আমি জানি তো ওই যে এখনো বিছানার নিচে বসে আসবে আর কি মাছ না আর বেরিয়ে যাবো না হলে
Don't be afraid to fall into my arms You know that I will hold